So we talk about the tone and the language of the diary entry. Mostly the simple past tense is used to record incidents and reactions that have already taken place. However, the present and the future tense are also used depending on whether the writer wishes to make a resolution or refer to a planning. So students, when we talk about the writing diary entry, mostly the simple past tense is used to record the incidents and the reactions that have already taken place, that have already happened. However, the present and future tense are also used depending on whether the writer wishes to make a resolution. If he wants to talk about the future time or the present time, or he wants to refer to any planning, future planning, then in that case, these both tenses, present and future, can be used. So use the first person narration and the active voice. As we know that this is a personal diary, this is a personal type of composition, so the author, the writer, can use the first person narration by using the pronouns like I, we, and can start the sentence with the active voice sentences like with the subject. Use a language that is chatty, friendly, and informal. So we know that there are many writing, most of the writing compositions, the informal language is not allowed. Even the friendly tone is not allowed. So we need to be formal and precise one. But here, as it is a personal document, the language can be chatty, like as you're talking to your friend, and it can be the informal one. Though informal, refrain from using short forms and slang for this diary. Entry will be assessed for writing style and mechanics. But even though the style would be the informal one, the tone and the language would be the informal one, but restrict yourself from using short forms, the contractions and the slangs for the diary entry, because it will be assessed for writing style and for the mechanics of writing, the intricates that you have to use in writing. So it's better not to use short forms and slangs while writing down diary. So emphasize on feelings, emotions and reactions rather than describing incidents. It's better to care of your emotions, feelings and reactions rather than just describing facts and incident. So now let's have a look on the sample diary entry and what is the format. As it's a personal document, it doesn't have any restricted format that one needs to follow. But even then, we need to keep certain things in mind while writing down diary. That the first thing, we need to mention date and day. The first with a day, then date. Then immediately after that byline, it would be time. As we know that mostly the diary entry is written before going to bed. So the suitable time would be like 8, 8:30, 9, 9:30, 10. So the preferable time would be this one, like after 8 and before 10. So leaving a line, one line space, you have to address your diary like a friend, that you can say, dear diary. So today, as you want to express your feelings, that how did you spend the day, what has happened with you throughout the day, so you can describe that incident that happening to your diary as you are mentioning some incident to your best friend. Like, let's read out what has written as in a sample. Today was my 14th birthday. My parents took all my friends and me for a picnic to celebrate my birthday. They made all possible efforts to make it really a memorable day for all of us. Delicious food, exciting games, and lovely return gifts. My friends reached my house at 9 a.m. and soon we left for the picnic spot, a resort on the outskirts of the city. The fun started from that moment onwards. My mother had planned a sort of treasure hunt when were the friends in each one of the cars formed teams and searched for the treasure. Once we reached the picnic spot, we had even more fun with very interesting party games and mouth-watering food. After spending the whole day, we left the picnic spot in the evening. I thanked my parents for planning such an exciting birthday for me. Shahana. So, two, three things that you need to keep in mind while writing down diary, that the diary, as it doesn't have any strict format, but even then you can divide your diary into three passages. And at the last, it's a must write down to mention your name. So here, students, I'm going to share with you an exercise. I hope you would all complete in your notebooks following the same pattern. So let's read out. You have been appointed the head school prefect. You're very happy and resolved to perform your duties with utmost diligence, with utmost hard work and dedication. So write your diary entry for that day when you had been appointed as a head school prefect, and how did you feel, what was your feelings, emotions, what was your reaction. So describing all, you have to write down this diary entry, and really I expect that you will complete your work and you have understood well about the diary entry. So it's all about to express your feelings. So students, complete your work till the time. Stay safe, stay happy. Thank you.